What kind of dimensional modeling should you follow in order to create the data model? Okay, so when I say dimensional modeling, okay, you have two main dimensional modeling. Okay, that is star schema and snowflake schema. Okay, so we have to get to a conclusion which dimensional modeling you should follow in order to create your data modeling. Okay, so now the main keywords would be your dimension tables and fact tables when you go for dimensional modeling. Okay, dimension tables are nothing but the tables, consider them as tables, okay, in a simpler words, which the dimension or a table which would have textual data. Okay, suppose when you have product, you'll have product ID, product description, okay, all the textual information of that product. Okay, so product table is your dimension table. When I say fact table, a place or a table where you save all your measures. Measures are your numerical values. Okay, suppose consider sales, profit, quantity sold. Okay, all these are numerical columns, right? So all the numerical columns would be saved in your fact table. Okay, fact table will have only the relational columns, that is your foreign key columns and your numerical measures. Okay, whereas dimension tables will have textual attributes. Now let's see what is star schema and snowflake. Okay, star schema is nothing but you have a single fact table which acts as a center table where all the dimension tables would surrounding it would be connected to it. Okay, that is you have only one fact table which would be a center table where all the dimension tables would be connected to your fact table. Okay, this is your star schema looks like, how it looks like. Now consider the same sales information. Okay, so now we have we should have a dimension which would save store your customer information. Okay, so now we have customer dimension. Similarly, don't consider this. This is just a duplicate of this. Okay, ignore this part, yellow one. And in order to save all the product information, we need a product dimension, right? And we have store information to identify what store it is and where is it located at. Okay, now, so all the description columns would be available in your dimension tables. Okay, and now we need to identify the sales of it. Okay, and for each order, what is the amount being paid or that the organization is receiving. Okay, so your fact table will have, okay, consider this as an order table. Okay, fact table or order table. Now it will have all the order information along with the quantity that has been ordered and what is the total amount that has been paid. Okay, so if you see, as this is the fact table, it should be connected to all the dimension tables, right? So how do we connect it? As I told you, the primary key in each dimension would act as a foreign key in your fact table. Okay, now suppose if you want to query for customer ID 1, what is the quantity ordered and what is the amount he has paid. Okay, so you need a common column, right, in order to get the quantity ordered by that particular customer. So you will say, when customer ID in my customer table is matching with the customer ID in my order table, show me the quantity that has been ordered. Okay, similarly, in order to know the product sales, you need the product ID as a foreign key in your fact table. So this is how star schema looks like. Okay, when it comes to star schema, it is not a normalized one. Okay, whereas snowflake schema is a normalized one. Okay, so if you consider the same data, how it looks in that star snowflake schema is we make this. Okay, if you have a time dimension, what happens in snowflake is we normalize each dimension. Okay, and then we have a hierarchy of dimensions in a snowflake schema. Okay, this is the only difference between star and snow. Okay, star is not normalized, whereas snowflake is normalized. When I say normalized, what we are doing, we are dividing one table into multiple tables, right? That is, we are forming a hierarchy of your dimensions. Okay, consider time or a store location. Okay, so when I say store location table, I'm normalizing this to identify state as a different dimension, city as a different dimension, and country as a different dimension. Instead of having all this at the same location, we have normalized it and formed different hierarchy of tables to it. Okay, so now when I form hierarchy, your first level would be your country, then you will have state, then you will have city, and then you will have street or a location of it. Okay, so the main disadvantage of Snowflake is the query processing time. Okay, consider I want to get complete location of a store. Okay, so I have to query all the way from country, I should get state, then I should get city, then I should get the location. Okay, so your query processing time would be more because you have to query four tables instead of one table in star schema. Okay, so this is one of the disadvantages with Snowflake schema, is the query processing time. Okay, now let's see an example of star schema. Okay, so consider product table and your store table, then you have your customer table, the center one is your order table or your fact table. Okay, now consider I want to know a product P1's order details. Okay, what are all the orders that have been placed on product P1? Okay, so now my fact table is having the order information, right? So now I join my product table with my fact table based upon my product ID. Okay, I'll say when my product ID is equals to P1, give me order ID. Okay, so now a list of order ID should be populated when you run this query. Okay, so now what it does is it will check for product ID column where the entry is P1. Okay, now I have two P1s. Okay, that is two orders are placed on your P1, product P1. Okay, the output would be two records, your order number 100 and 105. Okay, similarly, if you want to know if order in a store C1, okay, what are all the orders placed? Okay, similarly, as a store ID, which is a foreign key column over here, would help you connect these two tables. Now I'll say select order ID from fact table. Okay, from store ID, join with fact table on store ID column where your store ID is equals to C1. Okay, now again you have two orders in happened in store ID C1, which is your 100 and 102. Clear with the terminology, right? So when I say dimension, is nothing but your table, okay, where you have a description columns. Okay, fact table is the one with your numerical values. Okay, all the numerical measures like sales, profit, discount, okay, all this information, profit ratio, all this information would be stored in your fact table. Okay, and all these are your attributes. Okay, entries, columns in your table are known as attributes. Okay, whereas numerical columns are known as measures. Okay, measures are nothing but you have a column on which you can perform some aggregations on. Okay, you have sales. Okay, you can perform sum of sales, right? Or you can have minimum of sales or maximum of sales. Okay, columns on which you can perform aggregations on, or a numerical column, is nothing but your measure. Okay, and there is another data modeling, okay, which is your fact constellation. Okay, we cannot always say that only one fact table would be necessary in your data model. Okay, consider you have different areas of data. Okay, suppose consider the same example. You have sales information and you also have inventory information. Okay, who is the supplier and what is the inventory fact, inventory table and all. Okay, so you cannot save inventory data in your fact table, right? So we might need to have two fact tables now. Okay, where your inventory table would be connected to your product and supplier and time. That is, which product is supplied by which supplier and on what date. Okay, and now you have inventory. Now you will have sales on that products, right? So you have a sales table which would store the customer information by what's the sales happening by each customer, what's the sales happening on each product, and at what location and what date. Okay, so whenever you have multiple areas of interest in your data, then we go for multiple fact tables. Okay, because you cannot, there is no way you can have inventory information and fact information in the same table. Okay, so then we go for fact constellation. That is nothing but having multiple fact tables in your model.
I'm sure you enjoyed learning from this video. Please like the video, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment us in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more information, visit our website now. Keep learning with Intellipaat.